Hey folks, my name is Jared Manninen, and I'd like to welcome you to my monthly newsletter. At the beginning of each month, I publish a newsletter filled with photos, videos, artwork, links to my other projects, and an essay that I hope will provide food for thought and a starting point for meaningful conversation. Keep in mind, however, that these video versions of my newsletters have been modified from their original format. So if you want to read any of my previous newsletters, visit jaredmanninen.com. Thoughts about preparing for winter. Winter is my favorite season by far, but this hasn't always been the case. Rather, historically, I've loved autumn most of all. And the reason for this is because I associate it with the beginning of the school year. I know that sounds funny, especially since I haven't attended a traditional school in years, and I don't have any kids through which to live vicariously. However, I've always equated school and fall with new beginnings. When going to school, those new beginnings manifested in the forms of learning new information and skills and meeting new classmates. Even when reuniting with friends whom I hadn't seen for months, the old was made new because everyone changes. And those changes in people, no matter how subtle they are, always reveal themselves after extended bouts of separation. I also appreciated how school added structure and purpose to my life because toward the end of each summer, I no doubt spoke the phrase, "I'm bored," one too many times. Realistically, how many pickup games of baseball, basketball, football, or tennis can you play with the same friends over the course of an entire summer before you start to wonder if there isn't something more to life? I say this despite the fact that I would have never admitted that as a child. Lastly, having grown up in the upper Midwest with its abundant forests of deciduous trees, I learned to love the changing colors as well as the cooler temperatures associated with fall. The transitional nature of autumn weather essentially made every day feel like an adventure. If you weren't aware, for a number of years now I've been a seasonal worker in the outdoor recreation industry at Lake Tahoe. From late November through March, I work at a cross-country ski center, and from mid-May to October, I work at a family-owned summer resort, so I'm out of work during the quote-unquote shoulder seasons. In other words, I don't actually have a job during most of the spring and fall. This is because both resorts at which I work close due to the lack of business, which is a direct result of the change in seasons. After my hectic and structured summer job ends and before the snow flies, I have a decent amount of free time. On the other hand, most people have returned to their daily and weekly routines by the time I'm wrapping up work, since their kids, for example, are back in school. I know it sounds great to have all that time off during the fall, and I totally agree that it is. However, the weather isn't always on my side at that time of the year. Tahoe in October, for example, could be warm and sunny with 75 degree temperatures one day, but the next day may yield a high of only 45 with cold soaking rains, or vice versa. Back in October of 2015, I planned a 2-week backpacking trip along the long since defunct Tahoe Yosemite Trail. Again, this is thanks to having some time off during the shoulder season. The plan was to hike from my home down to Tuolumne Meadows, with my roommate meeting me after the first week at Sonora Pass to deliver my one resupply. As I set out, the 10-day forecast looked chilly but ultimately favorable for backpacking. I actually don't mind hiking in cold temperatures under overcast skies. By the third night, however, it started to rain. And the rain continued for the entirety of the next day. Needless to say, I was ill-prepared for dealing with low temperatures and that much constant rain. By the end of day 4, I was as close to becoming hypothermic as I've ever been, and this was after covering nearly 18 miles of trail. No matter how hard and fast I hiked that day, I just couldn't get comfortably warm. I decided to call off the trip upon reaching some shelter that night. Fortunately, I was at a location within a few miles of Sonora Pass, so the following morning, I quickly hiked to the road and managed to hitch a ride into Bridgeport. Later that day, my saint of a roommate drove down and picked me up. Much to my chagrin, the weather on that fifth day was absolutely perfect, blue skies and sunshine. But I had already made the call and was still feeling slightly broken from my previous day's efforts. So I acknowledged that the 60 miles that I covered over those 5 days was adventure enough this time around. And let it be known that the structure in which I sheltered during that adventure was technically an outhouse. Also let it be known that that was actually the second time in my life that I stayed overnight in an outhouse due to being caught in the rain while backpacking. Not exactly highlights of my life, but hey, we do what we can with what we got. As you might imagine, I don't schedule too many backpacking trips in October anymore. That's not to say that I wouldn't, because I still do go on shorter camping trips during the shoulder season. However, the volatility of fall weather has ultimately created within me a sense of urgency to take care of other business before it's too late. Just consider last winter, 2022-23, here in Tahoe, where the snow arrived on November 1st and essentially didn't stop until the following May. Sometimes it can just be a matter of a few weeks before we're in the thick of it. As I've gotten older and look forward more to winter than fall, I wouldn't say that my love of autumn has actually diminished. I now just appreciate it for slightly different reasons. I always have a to-do list of tasks that I try to complete before winter, which kind of feels like school homework. Those are usually home winterization projects such as splitting and stacking firewood, cleaning the gutters, purging any junk that's accumulated in the garage, and reinforcing various structures on the property. This also means that I start increasing my physical fitness capacity again, similar to participating in school sports. I'm in decent shape year-round, but by September I'm completely exhausted from the summer, so I revisit those single-leg strength and balance exercises, as well as increasing my cardio output. But this isn't only so that I can glide into the cross-country ski season without too many hiccups, it's also so that I'm prepared to shovel snow. Even though I'm no longer involved with school, most everyone I know, regardless of whether or not they're personally attending school or have school-aged children, still take most of their vacations during summer. And I work so much during that time anyway, both at my resort job and on personal projects, that I seldom see friends outside of my roommate and coworkers. So when autumn does roll around, I start reconnecting with my other friends and loved ones as if I were returning to school. Not surprising, we all tend to express a shared disbelief at how quickly the time has passed since last we spoke or saw each other in person. But it stands to reason since we're usually all scattered to the winds and on our own programs during the summer. So this community-related aspect of fall is something I've always appreciated about the season. It has a special way in which it brings people together and creates a sense of unity within a community. Regardless of whether or not you're looking forward to winter, it's on its way. Fortunately, we're all in this together, so let's prepare for what's to come. Okay, folks, we've reached the end of this presentation, so I thank you for tuning in. I hope you've enjoyed the show. If so, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any feedback or questions, post it in the comment section below. If you want to read previous newsletters, visit jaredmanninen.com and then check out my backcountry blog, tahotrailguide.com. where I offer information about hiking, backpacking, cross-country skiing, and snowshoeing at Lake Tahoe. I also write general and how-to articles about those activities, as well as informative articles about Sierra Nevada, flora and fauna, and the local history of Lake Tahoe. Thanks again, and take care, everyone.